This lesson is about how processes get started in Linux. It takes two steps, but before I can describe the procedure, I need to explain a little bit about what a process is. A program is an executable file. A process is an instance of a program that is in execution. As we have seen, there can be lots of programs in execution at any one time. This is sometimes called multitasking. A process can be divided logically into three parts. The executable code, the instruction portion of the process, is called the text. Now, this isn't text in the sense that you and I are accustomed to. It isn't a bunch of readable ASCII characters. This text is the binary code, the set of instructions that can be loaded into the CPU of the computer and executed. Another part of the process is the data. Every process has data, and the data is kept in a separate area of memory than the text. The third part is not actually a part of the program. It's the information maintained by the operating system. It contains the address of the two parts of the process ID, the parent process ID, the program status, and so on. The Linux system keeps a context for each process and switches execution from one to the other, and this is in effect multitasking. The two parts loaded from the program file, the text and the data, make up the memory resident form of the program. The text portion of the process is constant, it never changes. The data section, on the other hand, is dynamic and changes constantly as the program runs. This means that two instances of the same program can share the same text in memory. For example, if there are several bash shells running, each one of these bash shells uses the exact same text segment in memory, but each one has its own private data segment. Now let's say that one process, such as a bash shell, wants to start another process running. It's a two-step procedure. The first thing the process does is fork itself. This creates a new context with a new PID number and makes a duplicate of the data segment in memory. At this point, there are two identical copies of the bash process running. It has cloned itself. Then the clone, the new copy of the bash process, replaces itself with a different program, the one you wanted to run. That is, it execs another program. A data segment for the new program is loaded from disk and put in the place of the existing data segment, and a copy of the text of the new program is loaded into a new location in memory. Of course, if an instance of the new program was already in execution on this system, then it's not necessary to load another copy of the text. The one that's already loaded is used. And that's it. The new process is then running. This fork and exec process occurs whenever you enter a command from the bash shell and the shell runs a program as a response. The new process, even if it only exists briefly, has its own context and its own PID. For example, the shell spawned the LS process using fork and exec, and then it waited until the new process had finished before prompting again for more input. Let me show you how this works with something that runs a bit longer. There is a little program named sleep that runs by doing nothing other than sleeping for the number of seconds you specify. For example, it can be made to sleep 10 seconds like this. Notice how the bash shell is politely waiting for it to finish before continuing with another prompt. But you can request that the bash shell not wait by adding an ampersand to the end of the command line. You can do this with any command you enter. It causes the process to run in the background instead of in the foreground. The prompt comes back, but the process is still running, and you can see its PID number, and we can prove it's running with PS. There you see it. It has its own PID number. When it finishes, it'll report that fact to the bash shell, and the shell will report that to you. But the shell won't interrupt what you're doing to tell you. It'll wait until after you've hit the enter key after entering another command. There. You can see that the sleep process is no longer running, and the shell has reported that fact. Now, this is not just the bash shell. Any process in Linux can start another process by doing fork and exec. There are system calls named fork and exec that you can use from inside a program to do this, but this is not a programming course, so I'll leave that for another time. The next lesson describes some special situations that can arise from this parent and child relationship of processes.